Welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and today I'm going to be filming this look right here. This is using all drugstore makeup. I don't love how this look turned out. The foundation really screwed up the whole look. My foundation is super heavy and super cakey. It's really showing all the texture in my face. It's showing all the fine lines. So I don't really like it. I don't really like how the look turned out. It was kind of a flop, but it was fun. And not because I used drugstore products was a flop. It was a flop because the foundation screwed everything up. Because I use drugstore makeup for a full face all the time and it turns out gorgeous. It's just the foundation just didn't work out for me. But yeah, if you're interested to see how I created this look, or if you're interested to see the steps of this look, then just keep on watching. Alright, so I'm gonna start off by priming my face. The Nivea Men Post Shave Balm. Ready my foundation. Alright, now that my face is primed, I'm going to jump into foundation. I'm going to take my CoverGirl Nature Luxe foundation. I haven't used this in a hot minute. It's been a very, very, very long time. Definitely like a couple of years since I've used this foundation because it's too dark. And it's oxidizing really bad. I don't have a dose of foundation. It's a lighter shade. And hopefully my neck and my shoulders won't be different colors. Makes a very glowy mixture, which I really like. Alright, I'm gonna take my CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous Concealer. I wasn't able to switch up this one because I just wasn't in the mood to do that. This foundation, I feel like it feels super heavy. I don't know, it feels like I have a lot of makeup on my face. I kind of feel greasy, which like, all my fine lines, all my pores. But we'll see once I get powder on it and see how that looks then. And set under my eyes with my mostly matte powder really quickly. You guys know I like to do this. My shoulders are not even. Okay. Set. Yeah, I definitely feel like that foundation really did enhance a lot of my texture and sunk into a lot of fine lines. Once again, you guys will have my final thoughts at the end. Bronze to the face. Just a bronze. I'm not going to contour today. This is my NYC Sunny Bronzer. Just to bring my face some warmth. R2 brush. But yeah. My forehead keeps like coming up and saying like, stop recording. Like, eat my asshole. I'm sorry, Mom. I'm really sorry you had to hear that. It was not me. It was not your holy Christian daughter who just said that. Alright, now I'm gonna blend away this bake really quickly. Above eyelids. I'm such an idiot. Oh my god. Alright, so that much is done, and now we're going to move on to the eye. And I use my Wet n Wild Naturale palette right here. This is really, really affordable. It's like $4 or something from the drugstore, of course. So it's easy to get your hands on if you're on a budget, because makeup is expensive, dude. Makeup is really expensive. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and take this shade right here for a transition shade. It's like a cool toned mauve pink shade. I'm just going to blend that right in the crease. Alright. Okay. I'm going to go in with the shade right next to that transition shade, which is this dark plum-ish color. And I'm going to go on a Morphe E18 brush and just going to pop that right on the outer V. This is really pigmented. Oh my god. Oh my god. Ooh, girl. And I go over this just to soften the edges everywhere. See, this is where these eyeshadows kind of become a little more tricky to blend out, which. For $4 eyeshadows, again, you get what you pay for. You can't really complain. They are good shadows. And you know, I don't do a lot. A lot of people, I feel like, don't do a lot. It's interesting. I feel like I do want a nice little wing, though. I think I do. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do a quick little wing liner. Alright guys, so my eyeliner is done. I ran out of my eyeliner, so I had to kind of be resourceful. And I used some black eyeshadow and some mascara to do my wings. They're not the best wings, but hey, they work. It's whatever. I'm gonna spray my face again now because it looks really powdery after all of that. All that. Okay, I'm gonna put on my mascara. I'm gonna take my Maybelline cat eyes, of course. Just like that. I do like this eye look. Actually, it's really pretty. It's just really different from what I typically do on my eyes. So, I mean, that's obviously hard to get used to, but it's whatever. I am going to highlight my face because it's looking really, really matte, and I don't like that because I just don't like how a matte face looks anymore. I used to live for it. I don't like it anymore. So I'm going to highlight my face. I'm going to go with my e.l.f. Prism palette. It has a bunch of shimmery shades, amazing highlighting colors. I'm going to use these two shades right here to highlight my face. I'm really going to take it there today because I'm feeling extra matte. I don't want that. I do not like being matte. I just hate it. I think it looks so scaly, and I think it makes you look so old. Huh? Iridescent. Pink? What's left? Alright guys, that was the entire look. Thank you so much for being here and watching. If you guys enjoyed, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. If you want to, if you want my face to show up in your subscription box every time I post. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Be sure to tag me on your Instagram or Twitter. Twitter or Snapchat me pictures if you decide to create this look. My social medias will be down below in the description box, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys!